Hey, and welcome to this video about index funds for beginners. So in this tutorial, I'm going to do an in-depth view about index funds, ETFs, and other options available to you as an investor. So make sure to leave a comment below if you have any questions about index funds, or tell me what your favorite index fund is. If you're new here, be sure to subscribe to the channel to stay up to date with other investing videos like this one. And I do ask that if you get some value from this video, to hit the like button below. So index funds basically are a basket of stocks that an investment firm offers out to different individual investors, and they can be on a stock market index. So a stock market index, for example, like the S&P 500, that is the top 500 US companies across a range of different sectors. So you have the likes of Vanguard, which is one of the most famous investment firms. What they'll do is they will go and they'll buy the 500 stocks that track the S&P 500, and then they will offer out this fund for different investors to invest in. So you as an investor, you don't have to go and buy those 500 stocks that are on the S&P 500. You can just go and buy this index fund that Vanguard offers. And this saves you a lot of time from having to go and actually individually look at those 500 companies and buy them yourself. You can just go and buy it for a lot cheaper on Vanguard, and it would be a lot of cost there as well if you were to buy 500 stocks as opposed to just buying a little piece of it, which is offered through Vanguard and other investment management companies out there that offer this kind of service. So there are lots of different investment firms that offer stock market indexes out there. My two favorites are Vanguard and iShares. So you will see that there are investment firms and they're offering index funds across a lot of different stock markets in the world. So for example, you could look at the FTSE 100 in the UK. You could look at the CAC 40 that's in France. You could look at the DAX 30 that's in Germany, and in the S&P, as I mentioned, that's in the US. So the reason it's called, you know, that it has numbers after the names of these different stock markets is that's how many companies are within their top tier of the stock market index. So the FTSE 100 has the top 100 UK companies, CAC 40 is the top 40 French companies, and so on. So you're probably wondering, why is indexing so popular and why have you heard about it a lot more? Well, the reason it is so popular is because it's a passive investment strategy. So you as an investor, you don't have to spend much time to be invested in the markets if you're taking this passive approach and investing in indexes. You're depositing the same amount each month into your brokerage account, and you can go and buy an index fund then as well. You don't have to spend lots of time going, looking at individual companies, getting under the fundamentals for them and seeing if there's any specific risks that are attributed to that one individual company. You're spreading your risk here by going and doing this, by doing indexing. And you're basically, what you're doing is you're betting on that economy going up. So if you are betting on, if you have a FTSE 100 tracker, for example, you're betting the UK economy will perform well. And if you have a CAC 40 one, you're betting on the French economy performing then as well. So, I mean, the reason this is so important is because if you have an economy that's performing well, the stocks in that economy should perform well as well. And you'll see the profits growing from them in line with the stock market. So the stock market on average, it grew from 7 to 10% since its inception, if you took every year and you average it out. If you are invested in an index tracker fund like this, you can benefit from that growth in the stock market by having your risk completely diversified and not betting on individual companies. So the second reason then that index investing is so popular is because it's low cost. So it's not expensive to go out and buy one of these trackers that are offered by the various different investment companies out there. You can go in and you can buy it for a very low cost compared to what it would be if you were to get your money actively managed by a financial advisor. To see how much it would cost in an index fund, go and look at the expense ratio. So the expense ratio will tell you, out of the total sum you have invested in that tracker, how much you're going to be charged on an annual basis to have that investment. So if you look at the Vanguard S&P 500 index fund that they offer, they charge 0.04% on this. So this, compared to what you would pay a financial advisor, that 1 to 2% is a massive difference. And it really is passive, because you can invest this on a monthly basis and just put it into that tracker again without having to look at any different company or to spend a lot of time there. With this, if you look at that 1 to 2% that a financial advisor charges you, it doesn't seem like it is much, but if you're someone who's invested investing, say, 1 million, that's going to be 10 to 20,000 every year. And that really adds up over the long term if you take it over a 5 to 10 year time frame. So looking at it, last year, only 29% of actively managed funds in the US ended up beating the S&P 500. And that was after the fees were reduced from those actively managed funds. So if you think about that, 71% of active fund managers failed to beat the S&P 500 and how that performed last year. And that really is just ridiculous if you think about it, because you're putting your money in, you're paying someone to go and manage your money, but they can't even beat a passive investment strategy that you can do so easily yourself. You can set up with your brokerage account, put monthly deposits in, and end up buying a tracker. So it really is not great to be paying large fees into an active fund manager when 71% of them can't even beat the S&P 500 after expenses. And the third point then that these are so popular is they diversify your risk. So index funds, if you are investing into these, you're investing in a diversified portfolio, and this can really protect you against the risk of not being diversified enough and having enough holdings. Because if you're invested in, say, 3 or 4 stocks, if one of these takes a downfall, your whole portfolio is really going to suffer there. Whereas if you're spread across 500 companies or 100 companies, it's going to have to take a lot of them to take a downturn for your portfolio to be impacted. So there is something that's called idiosyncratic risk in a portfolio, and this is the risk you have in your portfolio from not holding enough companies in it. You can completely get rid of this risk if you hold up to, they say the magic number is 15, having 15 uncorrelated bets of stocks in your portfolio to get rid of idiosyncratic risk. So by buying an index fund, you can get rid of this risk completely and you don't have to worry about it. Whereas people who invest in a small amount of companies, they'll always have this risk apparent in their portfolios. By buying an index fund, you'll alleviate this, and then you will be able to do it on a low cost basis as well. That will be very simple for you and not time intensive. So for you to go and actually buy 15 stocks that are uncorrelated, it will take you a lot of time to look into these different stocks to see that there's no correlations. As well, it will actually just be very time intensive to look at the 15 companies you want to buy as well. It's a lot easier to just go and buy an index fund, especially if you're someone who doesn't have much accounting or finance knowledge. It's so simple to just put it into this passive tracker on a monthly basis. The next point then, why indexing is so popular, is because of the individual risk that you get away from. So you don't actually have to stay on top of the different companies you're invested in and look at the individual risk that each one of these poses. Whereas if you're invested in, say, 3 or 4 stocks again, you'll have to be staying on top of the earnings with these companies, all the different changes that they have, such as in their management or different strategies that they have, to make sure that it's still a sound investment for you. Whereas if you have your risk spread over so many different companies, if 1 or 2 companies are making changes to their strategy, it's not going to have a massive impact on your portfolio. So it saves you from doing this time intensive work of going and looking at these reports and seeing if there is any individual risk that you can see in those companies there. Look, the best thing for you to do as an investor is to do a lot less and remove your ego from the table. So by doing a lot less, I'd say to just go and invest in those trackers. Like you've seen, like that point I touched on earlier, that a lot of active fund managers can't even beat the market. So, you know, what are the chances of you getting involved in investing now and actually beating the market in 1 or 2 years' time? They're very low if you think about it. With these guys are outspending, and they've spent their whole livelihood getting up to date with financial modeling and different valuation models. And if they can't even beat the market, then there's a very, very slim chance that new novices getting into this market are going to have the chance to do it. So it would be just better to spend as little time as possible doing this, but then beat a lot of the fund managers out there by just taking that passive approach and investing into a large index. You can invest in a lot of different indexes across the world to make sure you spread your risk geographically, that you're not just invested in one economy in case there's a devaluation in their currency or some other factor that's going to impact that economy by itself.
Hey, thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel now to stay up to date with the latest videos. See you soon.